How is it that you hear a song you haven't heard in years and years and years, and immediately you can just sing it and you know the words and the tune? It's just like you've been singing it your whole life. How is that possible? And well, imagine our true reality, how easy it is to just get right back in the flow of reality like we never left. It'd be surprise us. Even like when I have songs on and have it on shuffle, and it may be like quite a while before I haven't played the songs, and I'll somehow know exactly what's the next song, or where I left off on the song a week ago, 2 weeks ago or something. I was like, how do you do that? I don't know. I just know what the next song's going to be, the next one, but consciously I have no idea. Subconsciously, I know. It just shows you what the subconscious knows. It's you know, entirely beyond what we expect. Pick up, I know exactly the lyrics where I stopped off, but consciously nothing. I'm blank. I have no idea. But I'll start singing right in with it like I never stopped, like I'd never taken any break at all. I've been doing that with the Beach Boys songs, just like, ooh, this is the way I always dreamed it would be. You know, just like right back into the music, just like I never left it. Pretty interesting. So this gives us some hope that we can get right back into the flow of reality as if we never tried to distract ourselves with the disempowerment program for the Prime Creator. We just like, oh yeah, I'm just right back in the flow, just like that. Like it's totally natural for us. I'm sure that's how it is, actually. It's how it's going to be, yeah. In the meantime, we have to keep reassuring ourselves that we can limit, certainly begin to limit the misfortune we have. So I happened to meet my friend that had that accident yesterday on Highway 17, the most notorious highway maybe in the United States throughout the decades. You know, it's really that dangerous. And well, the problem is we've had a heat spell, and then suddenly the fog comes rolling in and it mists on the asphalt, the road. And there's so much traffic going to the beach on the weekends. There's a tremendous amount of, you know, kind of oily, filmy residue on the asphalt. And then when the weather flips, you get this mist coming in. It gets it all wet, and the dewdrops act. This mist kind of brings all the oil to the surface, and it makes it extremely slick. And so my friend's an expert driver. He's a truck driver, for goodness sakes, hauling heavy loads. And he was just going in his pickup truck, and the pickup suddenly they just lost all control of the vehicle. Because of the slick roadways, what happened? There weren't any other cars involved at all. He just lost control of the vehicle, smashed into the concrete barrier, and spun around. And I was just all sorts of stuff. So it was extremely scary, extremely frightening. And just in the blink of an eye, it happened. But he walked away from it. I saw him this morning driving the work truck, and I had some gifts for him that I got him just to say thank you so much for, you know, diminishing your misfortuning. You know, he diminished his misfortune. It could have been a lot worse. As it is, you know, he diminished his misfortuning. So there's some grace at work right there. So, and he was, you know, he was really psyched, you know, very, very grateful. Just like, wow, you know, thanks for thinking of me. It touched him, you know, and because it touched me that he walked away from it, you know, without a scratch, and now he's back at work, but he was shaken up. There's no question about it. It's you see your life flash in front of your eyes right there, and you think it's everything, you know, just in a blink of an eye, you know, it's just wow. And then you dig into it and see, you know, what could cause it. Well, Toyota pickup truck, older ones, very light in the back. The tires were pretty worn. The tread wasn't very good. The rubber's probably too hard. I asked an expert, you know, what kind of tires should you use? He said, you know, Bridgestone all-terrain tires are the best in those kind of conditions. He goes over 17 all the time fast, and he's tried many different tires, and he knows it. He says Bridgestone all-terrain tires. Good thing to know, right? Good thing to know. But those Toyota pickup trucks get really light in the back, and boy, it's so easy to spin those out and lose traction on them. There's no weight back there at all. Yeah, that's a problem with those lighter pickup trucks. So you know, you learn from it, you gain some knowledge from it. And you also got to realize, those conditions are extremely dangerous. How many people have crashed on that road and died in, well, my best friend died on that road in high school. He just went off a cliff. Yeah, who knows? Probably passed out. But yeah, I mean, so that road is a devil, for sure. But he walked away from it. To see him again, I was just like so psyched. I said, yeah, you did what you're supposed to do. Diminish your misfortuning, right? As we go towards just loving the freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow, we're going towards that. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. As we go towards that, we got to make sure we start diminishing our suffering, diminishing our misfortuning, choosing to have it diminished for us. We said, yeah, I accept some diminishment of my misfortune. Keep in mind that the universe is our strategy, investing our strategy in a program, a training program for the prime creator. And the whole point of the training program is to bring about so much misfortune for the prime creator that the prime creator will just quit being the prime creator. Yeah. So it's just vast misfortuning here. So we're so used to that we really have to consciously tell ourselves that we're willing to accept, diminishment of our misfortuning. No question about that. Don't think it's a nice universe. It's not. It's a dream. It's our dream. It's a dream of misfortune. It's a dream of disempowerment. It's a dream of disempowerment. So it's, you see it everywhere. I mean, it's just surrounded by misfortune. I'm talking to people every day. You hear about all the misfortune that they relate to you, and it's just, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Yeah, it's just crazy. And yet at the same time, we're wising up and saying, hey, I want to diminish, I'll accept the diminishment of my misfortune for sure. For sure. So I'm working on that because I have a lot of misfortune script in the future, as we all do. And I say, no, I don't want to, I'm not interested in that anymore. Forget it. But consciously, we have to keep it really simple right now and say, hey, just loving, freedoming from all misfortune. Wow. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Just loving freedoming from all, right here, right now. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now. Just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. And keep on telling yourself that. Remind yourself of what you really want. Remind yourself of what you really want. I didn't do a very good job today. I was working so ferociously, but I should have done a better job. That's for sure. But that happens. You just, if you have a little lull period, that's just how it goes. Don't worry about it. Just get right back and get into it again. So just loving freedoming from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortune. Wow. Just that. Just that, just that. We don't have to analyze misfortuning. What does that do? It doesn't end it at all. We have to remind ourselves we're willing to have freedoming from all misfortuning. Freedoming from all misfortuning. We're the ones scripting all of this misfortuning. Designing, testing, assessing this training program for the prime creator, hoping that it will just discourage the prime creator so that it quits. So we're doing this. So we have to back away from this and say, we don't need this. We don't need this. Got to remind ourselves, hey, I'm willing to accept freedom from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now. Just freedom from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now. Just freedom from all misfortune. Wow. Right here, right now. Just freedom from all misfortune. Wow. And just keep this reminder going. Keep this reminder going. So this morning I was, I'm getting real nervous about the Delta variant. That's now, they say it's doubling every 2 weeks in the United States. It's a thing. It's coming. It's worse. It's troublesome. And Of course, she's just like very concerned about it. Everybody is. I mentioned to people, say, "Don't say that." You know, it's like, I know it's terrible, but don't say it. I don't want to hear about it. And then you're talking about the jab, and you know what to do. Should you try to protect yourself with that, or what? You know, it's just like, it's just, and can you get any information from any spiritual teachers at all? Any advice? And the answer is no. I haven't found any advice at all. Nothing. Nothing, 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 actually. Nothing of any import at all. It's like, what? It's like, what? So I got really irritated with the whole spiritual hierarchy of helpfulness and the grace of the intrinsic ising. And then this sudden insight came to me. And I saw what's going on. And it was like, oh, okay, yeah. It was like, put two and two together. It's like, oh boy, wow. Yeah. And then this knowing told me, hey, do you really think that people will listen to what you say and accept it? And what do you think the reaction is going to be? I said, wow, they're going to be overly shocked and will not be able to accept it. And there's no way. And then this knowing voice sort of said, well, you know, that's why we're not really saying much anything out of what's going on, actually, because it's people would get so upset they'd forget to tell themselves, remind themselves, hey, right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Whatever is going on in the world, the bottom line is we have to accept freedom from misfortuning, all misfortuning. It's something we have to accept. Otherwise, it won't happen. So the bad stuff's going to continue on. The misfortuning is going to continue on if we don't accept freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow, right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow, right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. So if we don't accept it, if we don't focus on the remedy, then it doesn't matter how much we know about the troubles. We'll still be inundated by them. And the troubles in this world right now, it's another thing. If you really spill the beans on the full story, you know, you might get yourself in the world of trouble. I think there's folks that don't want the beans spilled. I don't need that kind of pressure on me. It doesn't really provide a remedy at all, actually. But the grace will tell you if you're ready and prepared. And I've been prepared. I know, studied my whole life what's really going on here and who's really involved. How extensive is the involvement, and where is it really coming from, and et cetera, in this world. So it's not a surprise what's going on here, and who's really pushing the whole thing. Yeah, I've given a lot of clues out in the past and kind of hinted and spoke of it in various ways, but now it's pretty obvious what's happening here. It's like, wow. Nobody's talking about it, actually, what's really going on. They're not at all. Completely missing the whole thing. That's why saying what's going on is it's not going to work, because people have no expectation of looking in that direction at all. The universe is a very bizarre place. It's not just this world that's very bizarre. It's the whole universe is very bizarre. Keep this in mind. That's a hint. The whole universe is a complete freak show. Complete disempowerment freak show. We think that, we hope, you know, is there any place where people are like, or where we can find some sort of normalcy in the universe and stuff? No. It's an insane asylum, plain and simple. People driven mad, crazy by, you know, trying to develop a training program to discourage the prime creator to such an extent it quits being the prime creator, you're going to go through a lot of weirdness in such a training program. And the whole universe is doing this. So, you know, this idea that somehow there's some the universe has something really benign for us. No, it doesn't. A freak show is what it is. I mean, demands fragility, you know, just all of this stuff that's going on. Wow. So that's the shock, you know, that's the shock. Is how can you really accept the whole universe is an insane asylum? See, that's too difficult for people. It's too difficult. So you don't, we don't want to be too specific about what's going on here. But you can kind of put two and two together here bit by bit and then ask the grace of intrinsic ising, you know, for help, to help you on this. But, you know, we still have this, we're not done with, you know, the troubles in the world at all. Yeah. So that's why we really need to just, right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. Like that. Really important. Keep the remedy simple and stay focused on the remedy. Stay focused on the remedy by keeping it really simple. So we're, you know, trying to do this, trying to do this. Right here, right now, just freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. Right here, right now, just freedoming from all misfortuning, wow. And there's a lot of misfortuning going on in the universe. And, you know, this... everyone has their point of view. Everyone has a narrative. Every, you know, it's just the whole universe is this way. So it's not the answer. The universe isn't the answer at all. It's the question. It's not the answer. The answer is to turn the universe over to the grace of the intrinsic ising, and you'll get back a glorified universe ing. Which is just an extremely effective reminder of how reality actually functions. And then we'll really gain confidence, like, hey, I don't think I'll have any problem with, you know, I was saying it today, got into it again today, and I realized this is a great analogy. No matter what I was vocalizing, and the risks I was taking, just anything, I never had a worry that I'm going to get stuck. Never have a worry that I'm going to get stuck. Now, how about that for creativity? You know, what is it, the creativity, you feel like you're stuck, right? When I'm vocalizing, I never feel stuck. No stuckness whatsoever. It would be extremely rare if I ever feel stuck. It just doesn't happen because it's just, I could just go any direction instantly. And this is very... you know, evocative of reality, actually. You're never stuck. Your creativity is never stuck in reality. Any direction at all is the flow. And you're never stuck. Never stuck. And so I had that feeling. I can vocalize in any which way, and there's no such thing as a dead end or a side trip or, oh, you know, that's... it's just keep flowing. Like, what are you going to do with this? It's like, I'm trying something really, like, and part of me saying, wow, you know, it's like, what? You know, this, I don't know where this could possibly go. And it's like I said, it doesn't matter. You know, it's, I can always make it go. I can always make it go. So this is like almost, you know, creative nirvana, you might say. But it's just a faint, shadowy pointer towards the nature of reality. Ing, it's always inging, just inging. Wow, never stuck. You see, some people are like very verbally facile and agile. You know, they could just—they never verbally stuck for something to say, like an Oscar Wilde or something. You know, it's just so. You know, they just never feel like I'm never in a corner. I'm never boxed in. That kind of thing. Except vocalizing is much more creative and fluid. It's just, you're not stuck to words. You can make any sound at all. It doesn't have to make any sense. it's just that you're flowing it. You're flowing the whole situation. You're just flowing it, and that's, you know, that's the feeling. You feel great. I mean, it feels wonderful to not be stuck. You're having being creative and not being stuck at all. And not even worried about being stuck. Because you can make any vocalization at all. There's no box to be in. It's like, well, I need to sing this way. There's no such thing. I need to sing anything in any particular way. I sing it every which way. Every which way. And do so. I gave us some great stuff today. Just fabulous stuff. And shifting the songs around, doing like Donna the Prima Donna by Dionne and the Belmonts or the Del Satins, whichever group who he's with, backing group. I just put something extra in there. Yeah, Donna the Prima Donna, Donna the Prima, and that's not in the song, but I was adding it on and it just sounds so balanced and great. Wow. And then just doing other stuff like that just all the time. Let me throw this in here. Let me do this. Let me do that. Let me add this. It's like a studio session kind of thing. Everything sounds good. Yeah. You might like something a little better than other things, but it's still you're not stuck anywhere. If something sounds good, you can still come off of that, spin off of that, and you'll do something else. It's just you can't lose. You can't lose. It's that feeling you just can't lose. Can't get stuck, can't lose. But doing that, if people are buying tickets, you know, they expect to hear what they want to hear is the problem. But if you're just by yourself, you don't have to satisfy anyone except you just the feeling of I can't get stuck. My creativity is just can't get stuck at all. So you're in this flow, just in this flow of you can do no wrong. You can do no wrong. So that's really a gift to yourself to experience that. Forget about singing to other people, really, for the most part. Do a gift to yourself, vocalizing, or whatever you do creatively. Just work for this feeling like, you know, I'm never stuck. I'm never stuck. No matter what I do, I always feel like I'm in the driver's seat in total control. And I'm on a great trip here. This is a great trip. You're going cross country and it's like all these different things. But you say, I'm totally in control of the vehicle and it's no problem at all. No problem at all. My friend told me he fixed up a Jeep, an old Jeep with roll bars. He'd go off-roading. He said he flipped it a bunch of times, rolled over and everything. He says, no problem. Just keep on going. It's like, see, so it's like he was never, you know, stuck. There's another example of never being stuck. He sold his motorcycle, too dangerous. He said he started from a green, red light turning, and someone had dropped some oil or transmission fluid or something on the road, and the bike just went right out from underneath him, just poof, like that. He said, if I was going faster, you know, bad accident. And he said, yeah, motorcycles, you're gonna dump it for sure. This is what my friends that ride motorcycles say. There's no question about it. You're gonna dump it bad. And, you know, there's two kinds of motorcyclists. Those are in the hospital and those are on their way to the hospital. And so he said, nah, it's too dangerous. Smart. Yeah. So do yourself a favor and allow yourself to be experience some creativity from coming from yourself rather than from someone else, where you let yourself get good enough at it where you just feel like you can just go anywhere, any different direction. Listening to these really great artists like Dionne or the Beach Boys or, you know, various, it's so difficult to not get entrained into their creativity because you think, oh, they're the best. And so if I sing exactly what they're doing, it's going to sound great. True, but it's better to not sing what they're singing and to add all sorts of different touches and different treatments of the song so that you feel in your own creativity. When you're singing along with them, you're kind of like feeling their creativity, but when you're transposing everything in your own way, then you're feeling your own creativity flowing like that. And also their creativity is there too, but you're also just, you're right there too with your own creativity adding to it. You've really made the whole thing even better, so to speak. So that's similar to reality. Everybody's harmonizing. There's all this harmonizing going on. And whatever way any creativity goes, you can just flow with it, and you're right there, and you're making it, enhancing it too with your, it's just it this is that this is what our creativity is capable of. This is what it does naturally. It's indomitable, it's unstoppable, it's cannot be trapped, cannot be diminished, it's just always just in the driver's seat so beautifully. That's reality, really. And the more you do it, the better you get at it. It takes some guts to do it, and you think, well, I'm gonna fail, I'm gonna get stuck, I'm gonna sound terrible, and so I've been singing a long, vocalizing a long most of my life, and only gradually, seeing what's actually possible. Mostly, it was always just singing along with what they were singing, and so I could say that sounds good, sounds good. And I didn't think I was capable really of, just lighting the whole thing up in a whole different way. And it's only recently that's come into the picture. But I'm telling you, it's definitely possible to do this. Like with Dion, I didn't used to be able to harmonize at all with him. I had he's too good. Now I'm just all over the place, absolutely all over the place, like it's a piece of cake. So that's just huge progress, huge progress. Beach Boys, the same thing. You think like, wow, they did it perfect. Well, who am I to do anything different? That kind of thing. But that's not the point. With creativity, it's like it's always perfect. You can't go wrong. You can't lose. You can't lose. So start to spread your wings and fly. Start to spread your wings and fly. You feel like you're flying finally, right? Instead of walking, you're flying now. And people might frown and say, that's not how they're singing it. I get that reaction. That's why I don't let anybody hear me. No, what are you doing? That's not how they're singing it. This is that. Well, this is how it's being. This is how it's. This is a combination situation. Now, this is how my harmonizing is going. This is how I'm reworking the whole feel of the whole situation. And you can do all sorts of timbre with your voice and make it soft and gentle or slow paced. As I was doing a Dion song, A Teenager in Love. Why must I be a teenager in love? Yeah. And you get into the mood like Dion was a heroin addict when he was doing this stuff. And so he was like really chill and seemed to just. You could feel that how relaxed he was when he was singing, and it wasn't trying to do it too fast or anything. It's just, and so I was able to just get into the mood of kind of catching that mood, and then the whole sound feels kind of smooth and dreamy and like that, without any drugs at all, without any drugs at all. So you could try capturing the mood of the song. And put yourself into that mood, and you realize your different voice, whole different creative sound, and everything. It's just like it's amazing how creative we can be if we're willing to be so with expression. And I prefer vocalization because there's no form to it, really. I mean, there's no form to it. It's not like some after like a painting. You paint a painting, and there's the painting, and it sits there forever on your wall. There's nothing like that with singing. It's gone. Whatever I did today, it's out in the universe, or out in everywhereness. If I have no attachment to it, there's this. You can't say, "Ah, oh, here it is," or something. No. And that frees you up to do something different next time. Every time I sing it different, do something different. So I prefer this type of creativity to anything I've come across in the world. So much creativity is about producing things, works of art, so to speak. This is much, much better. I'm so confident that I can sing tomorrow better than, or as good or better than I did today, that there's no reason to hold on to yesterday. Now that's, you know, we think like, oh, you did some great work of art. Well, you gotta, you know, hold on to that. It's a statue by the, you know, Michelangelo or something. It's a painting by Da Vinci or something. It's there forever. It's like, I don't want that. I want to feel like right here, right now, you know, I can come up with something that is just, I've never heard before, and I just love it. So that's like really putting faith in creativity, isn't it? Putting tremendous faith in creativity. That's the way reality is. We don't have to hold on to the past at all. The creativity that we had yesterday, or so to speak. But I just not even think about it. I don't even think about what did I sing? Is it, you know, generally, you know, I don't think about it at all. I did give one example today just for this video, but who knows? Tomorrow I don't have any preconceived ideas of what I'll listen to, how I'll be. It's just spur of the moment, spontaneous is all it is. And so we can do this. We can do it. This is doable. It's just that you don't hear much encouragement to do this, actually. People say, well, hey, well, you know, put it in form. Don't you want to record? But you're so good, you should record what you're doing. This, blah, blah, blah. No, that's not the point. That's not the point at all. The point is to get used to being so creative, you don't even have to worry about putting it into any form, lasting form at all. That's like hell, putting into some lasting form. I don't want that. Yeah, it's like, I don't even want that. Can you imagine like being a musician, you have a song and you have to sing it the same way all your whole life? Ah, that's like total hell. And when you don't sing it the way the audience wants, they really get mad. They don't like that at all. I understand you're used to having the song, but that's because you become a passive audience member instead of using music to inspire you to be more creative yourself, to find your own voice. That's what it's really there for, to find your own voice. That's what we want. You know, find your own voice. Find your own creativity. Get freeing from all misfortuning. Just freeing from all misfortuning. And so you're not stuck. You're not stuck anywhere. That's the what's that song? He's a rebel. I have to try that one. See where I can go with that one. See the way he
walks down. How's that go? Yeah, walks down the street. Boom. See the way he shuffles his feet. Boom, boom, boom. Why is he always the one that does the thing they've never done? Just because of that, they say, whoa, he's a rebel and he'll never be any good. He's a rebel because he never ever does what he should, just because they don't like what everybody else does. That's no reason why we can't share our love. He is always good to me, good to him I'll always be. He's my rebel, don't know. He's my rebel, don't know to me.
It's like boom, boom, boom. You could do something with that, right? And it's just, you listen to it a few times and just start. You have to find something that overlay that, or something that, you know, it takes creativity to say, okay, what kind of overlay that's just going to make the whole thing just like swing in a different way, but it still sounds great. It's now like moving in a different way somehow. You know, that's fun. That's fun.
Yeah, he's a rebel. Yeah, he's a rebel. Uh-huh. Yeah, he's a rebel. Uh-huh. Yeah, he's a rebel. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa, yeah. Always a rebel. Boom, boom. Always a rebel. Uh huh. In the background, something like that. Always a rebel. Uh huh. Boom, boom. Ooh, 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 ooh. Uh huh. Boom, 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 boom. And da 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 da. Always a rebel. They'll do all different sorts of things. You can try anything at all. Anything at all. There's nothing. Nothing's right or wrong. Nothing's right or wrong, but you just, when you got the song, you listen to it, you can just, all sorts of ideas are just like, ah, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. So you trust your voice, you know, the voice never lets me down. It's just always can come up with something. I have no idea what I'm going to come up with at all. So I don't like static forms of creativity, like painting. I can't be a painter now. It's like, ah, forget it. I love it where everything's just whatever you did before, it's gone. And you're right in the moment. Got to come up with something right now. Right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. And it's like then the creativity says, yeah, I love this. So this is what we love, believe it or not. We've gotten trapped in this whole notion of coming up with static stuff. Why? To try and disempower the prime creator. Get the prime creator so discouraged, like, wow, I got to stare and look at this painting for all eternity. My God, that's horrible. Let me out of this. Right. I mean, is anything more horrifying than even a beautiful painting? Like, I just got to stare at, you know, it's going to be there forever just looking at this static painting or sculpture or something. It's like, ah, God, that's horrible. Yeah, either way he walks down the street. Yeah, either way he shuffles his feet. Why is he always the one? Why is he always the one? Does the things that shouldn't be done, done. Just because of that, they say. Hey. And so you start doing all this jiving around with the lyrics and stuff. I see the way he walks down the street. There's another one, see? See the way he shuffles his feet. Why is he always the one that always does the thing? Dun. Things that they say can't be done. Dun. He did that. Dun. I'm done. Why is he always the one? Does the things they say can't be done. Dun. And just because of that, they say, hey. And he just starts, you know, he just seasoning it up and juicing it up and just expanding it and adding all sorts of layers to it. And just from a simple song like that, you can do anything you want to do. And then, you know, it's gone. It's not sticking with you. It's not sticking with you. So the creativity can keep forming any way it wants to. Instead of saying, well, I just did it this way. So that's now set in stone. I can't have set in stone. There's nothing set in stone. Nothing set in stone. That's wonderful. And people panic, say, well, I did something good. I got to set in stone. No. You just proved yourself that you're best when you're not setting it in stone. The less you set it in stone, the better you get. This is true. This is what I'm experiencing. Getting better and better and better by just letting it flow and not setting anything in stone at all. Do lang, do lang, do lang. Doolang, doolang, he's so fine. Doolang, 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 wish he was mine. Doolang, 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 and I'm gonna get him, and I'm gonna make him mine. It's a matter of time. He's a sweet talking guy. Doolang, doolang, doolang. You could do something with that too, probably, couldn't you? Any song, but the simple ones. You can find ones that it makes it easier to do stuff, right? They're not trying to overwhelm you. Like, hey, I just recorded 100 different tracks, you know, and it's like, it's an experience that you just kind of overwhelm, like, I'm listening to this, wow. But those real simple songs, they're inviting you to add on and put little stinks, put stuff in, little vocal moves, little dance, vocal dance moves, you might say, vocal dance moves. Be danced through the song. Vocally dance through the song. Vocally dance through the song. You don't know how you can dance. It's whatever moves you want to put them in there. Put them in there. And this reminds us of something like, hey, didn't I used to function like this before? Like I got this feeling, this memory, like I used to be like just unstoppable, irrepressible. Didn't we used to be absolutely irrepressible? Yeah. Yeah, that's reality. Absolutely irrepressible. Wow. Just absolutely irrepressible. Wow. So just right here, right now, just loving, freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. And this is just this right here, right now, just totally irrepressible. Wow. Just totally irrepressible. Wow. Yeah, so we remind ourselves just of how completely irrepressible we are. Creative in all directions, just no end to it, no end to it. The more we do it, the better we get. Soft talking guy. Well, he's a soft talking guy. Oh yeah. Well, he's a soft talking guy. Ooh. Well, he's a soft talking guy. Soft talking guy. Yeah. Ooh. Well, he's a soft talking guy. So you can add that as background, some background thing, right? An overlay background is. Well, he's a soft talking guy. Like that. He's a soft talking guy. Repeat, you know, put it in between. You don't have to keep sticking with them vocally. You can like repeat what they just said in between before they say sing the next thing. He's a soft talking guy. He's a soft talking guy. Just a soft talking guy. Wish he were mine. I wish he were mine. And that dreamy boy, such a dreamy boy. Well, I'm gonna make him mine. And he's like, Well, I'm gonna make him mine. Just play off of what they're doing. Play off what they're doing. Like that. What's going on? Some crazy things going on in the distance there. What the heck was that? Wow. Well, I'm gonna make him mine. 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 You can just do all sorts of stuff. When you hear the music, you can do it 10 times better. I'm just imagining, you know, right now. It's very difficult. It's very difficult, but you get the idea. You're not constrained. You're not constrained. You can go any different direction. Swoop up, swoop down. Wave all over the place. Ripple all over the place. Just, it's like dancing. You make any dance move at any moment. Can't do it now because my legs are shot from COVID, long hauler. It just wipes out your legs. I have a hard time walking, actually. keeps kind of scraping my foot against the ground, like I'm not raising my foot up properly. Yes, it's horrifying. It compensate by, you know, vocalizing. It didn't take that away. So, you know, just right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. I couldn't find an oldie station. I tried to say, I want to sing along with oldie station. Couldn't find an oldie station on the stereo radio, vehicle's radio, FM, AM, nothing. It was all Spanish stations, pretty much. It's like, what? So I couldn't practice doing that. I have to do it on, you know, the YouTube, I guess, but in the room. But the driving, I want to listen to some oldies. Nothing. They say where the oldie stations are, but no signal. No signal. It's crazy. What's happened? Used to be KLIV. Like that. K, was it? Yeah. 1590 or something. Everyone's, they remember the days of the radio. Well, maybe some people don't, but you can just turn that radio on and just magic pours through your driving. It's just like a flow of this. You never know what it's going to be, what the style is going to be. I mean, listening to the music of the 60s, people say like the 70s was great. So, you know, you went there in the 60s. So the 60s starting out with, you know, Elvis in the early 60s and Bobby Darin, and then Dion, and then the Beach Boys, and then the Supremes and the Four Seasons, and all the girl groups back then, and the Beatles and the Stones and the whole British invasion and the psychedelic. I mean, the 60s was just like the richest musical time in history. It's just mind blowing. You listen to that stuff. It's just, I mean, the music I'm listening to is from the 60s and country from 50s, 60s and 70s, George Jones, Tammy Wynette, so just Melba Montgomery. Holy cow. I mean, the music was just devastatingly great. Because people really could sing back then. They really were into it, and they really, you know, it's different now. The technology is all studio stuff, right? You know, you bring anyone in the studio and make them, you know, turn them into a diva, kind of, in a lot of ways. Everything's auto-tune, auto-tone. Not back then. You had to be really, really good, and people were really, really good. There was so much vocalization going on in churches. That, you know, you're part of a choir, you're part of a quartet, you know, people were just singing. Look how great Elvis was, just as a young person, you know, just coming up and just busting it. Michael Jackson coming up, and, you know, just busting it. Just, there's people, you know, church singing is a big part of it. Yeah, they just sang all the time in church, and you sang really great. And they worked at it, and they practiced, and, you know, they took it real seriously, and then they knew how to put emotion into it and everything. And and then there's a super romantic era, the 50s, coming out of the 50s is ultra romantic era. Holy cow. Dreamy, romantic music. And then the 60s blended that with a little more of a beat, you know. So you had a combination of dreaminess and some beat. And it's just like, wow. Extremely amazing music. There's just always amazing stuff going on. There's different styles, for sure. But these days, you know, it's like there's no vocalizations that are worth, that are really great. It's in the advertisements for all products, and everywhere you go, it's electronic music. There's no vocalization going on. It's just incredible. The whole world of technology now uses just ambient electronic sounding stuff. Not back then. It was all vocalization. A lot of times just a cappella. But nowadays, it's sound effects. Electronic sound effects is pretty much what you're hearing. And it's like, you know, it's hard to flow with that, kind of, really, you know? You can imitate the sounds, all the electronic sounds, and do that too. So right here, right now, just loving, freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving, freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, now, right now, just loving, freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. Right here, right now, just loving, freedoming from all misfortuning. Wow. So just keep it real simple. Just remind yourself what you really want. You want freedom from all misfortuning, and you want to experience that creativity that's never boxed in. It's never trapped. It's never trapped. It's never trapped. Time for a cool change. That's a song, the Little River Band. So I can harmonize with them. The Bee Gees. I gotta try. I'm gonna try that. Maybe I get home from work and put on earbuds and YouTube and Wi-Fi and see how I can harmonize. I haven't really tried it actually. I just focus on certain artists that I feel are really helpful to learn how to do it and expand. You know, get better and better and better at it. The Bee Gees were a very good harmony group for sure. So there's a wealth of really great music in the 60s and 70s and 80s to harmonize with and to get, you know, help your creativity expand in a direct sort of way. I don't know how to put it. It seems like when you're doing using electronic instruments, I don't know, maybe some people feel really great doing that. It's not quite the same. I mean, it's like having something. Can someone dance for you? You know, I mean, if you want to know what dancing is like, don't you have to dance yourself? You know, you can't have something dance for you, really. No. So who knows how that plays out, but it's not a vocal time we're living in right now at all. They just fake it. They could take anybody and just do all this double tripling up and the way they do it in the studio now. There's so many effects that it's all these cool kind of electronic effects with your voice and things like that. But yeah, that's. It's different. Yeah. And maybe the people who listen to that, they, you know, they can get some creative flow out of that too, hopefully. Time for a cool change. I know that it's time for a cool change. Yeah. Time for a cool change. I know that it's time for a cool change. You know, you can do that in background, you know, so you just make it sort of fit in so it doesn't take the lead away from it, but it gives you kind of a wider resonance to it all. It's like I'm not stuck in this vocal box. Expressive box, this creative, great creativity, but I'm not stuck in it. You see this reality, great creativity everywhere, but I'm not ever stuck in it. I'm never stuck in it. So it's just practicing this. However great the Little River Band sang, you know, cool change, it's great. But you need to prove to yourself, I'm not stuck in it. I can enjoy it without being stuck in it. So music can be a real trap if you just listen to it. That'll actually get you depressed, to tell you the truth. It gets you very depressed. You need to prove to yourself that you're not, even however great the creativity is, you're never stuck in it. You're never stuck in it. So that's my attitude. I don't care what I'm listening to. I have to test it out. I haven't gone through all these different singers, but whatever I'm listening to, I'm not trapped in what they're singing. I appreciate and love what I'm hearing, but I don't feel like I'm trapped at all. I'm not going to be trapped. I can sing anything at all at any instant. Time for a cool change. That you can do it. Cool change. Time for a cool cool change. I know that it's time for a cool change. Change. Is there anything a little like that? Everywhere, it's just a sparkling everywhere. Just you can just grab this and grab this and grab this and time for a cool change. You play a little bit with the melody and things like that, but you can also do all sorts of different effects with it. It's time for a cool change. Well, it's time for a cool change. So you'd be doing that in the background. Well, it's time for a cool for the change. Well, it's time for a cool change. I know that it's time for a cool change. So you're in the background doing background singing to give it this, you know, little swing to it or something. Yeah. Okay, don't get caught just listening to, or don't be a spectator to creativity. Don't be a spectator to creativity. This can bring depression and despair. You say, I'm locked in this box now. I'm hearing this beautiful music, but I feel trapped. I feel trapped by it. I feel trapped by it. The best singer I've ever heard for helping you not feel trapped is George Jones, for sure. For some reason, he's just like, he's somehow inviting you to sing along, and he's not trying to trap you. It's amazing. It's amazing. So I started that way for, I've been singing with George Jones for a couple decades, actually. When I just listened to him today for the first time in quite a while. And right away, I just felt like, I could just go with this and branch off and invite, you know, it's a very, very helpful. Whereas other stuff, it's almost like it's sort of trying to box you and say, I got this beautiful music for you. Here it is. Enjoy it. But, you know, you just get stuck in it. You get stuck in it. Kind of like Beach Boys' Good Vibrations or something. You know, you listen to the song over and over and over and over. But that actually gets you depressed, creatively depressed. Gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with us. Gotta keep those. I mean, how can you sing that differently? Well, you can. You can. But it sounds so great. See, I don't want to do anything. I don't want to touch that. I don't know how it would do, but gotta keep those good vibrations. Gotta keep those good vibrations like that. Hey, you got to do something different. You can't just get trapped by that. You know, but it's very, very trapping, you know, that part. Da 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 da. You get trapped by that too. It's so great. You get trapped by it. You get trapped by it. Wow. So that may have contributed more than anything to my demise in this world. I was so surrounded by so much great creativity that I became a spectator and got trapped by it. And I felt like I lost my soul, you know, lost my soul, lost my spirit, lost my, what were we saying? The irrepressibleness. I lost my irrepressible spirit just listening to the Beach Boys. I said, oh my God, these are so good. I just got to listen to this. No more. You know, it's taken a lifetime to get out of that box. Woo. It's something like that. slide it around. I have to do it real quietly, so it's hard to do when it's really sotto voce. You're not trapped by it anymore. So I was wondering, how did I get so depressed? How did I lose my irrepressibility in this world? It's like baffling. But it may have been there's just so much great music that I just became spellbound by it. Spellbound by it. And then I tried to get out of it by playing electrical guitar and stuff, but it didn't work because it's the vocalization really that where it's really at, where it really gets you. You have to be able to vocalize your way out of the trap, so to speak. Most people, I would say, especially that vocalization music, yeah. Gotta keep. So I'll listen to it tomorrow. We'll see what happens. But I can something will happen. Gotta keep those open, love and good vibrations. Gotta keep those love and good vibrations. In the background. Gotta keep those loving good. You say, gotta keep those loving good vibrations. Yeah, gotta keep those loving good vibrations. And do something like that. Is he? So you're making it sound great, but it's different, and it balances out and harmonizes what's going on. But you're not trapped anymore creatively. You're not trapped anymore in it. California Girls, I mean, that's one of the most amazing songs ever. It's just, do 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 do, chun 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 chun. He's got orchestra comes in there, ching 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 ching, da 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 da. Do 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 do. Well, East Coast girls are hip. I really dig those styles they wear. And then they go, and the southern girls, well, it's the way they talk. They knock me out when I'm down there. Woo, you know, it's like, wow, the song's just an incredible song. I mean, it's just like mind-blowing. I mean, it still is mind-blowing. You listen to it now, and it's just like, what? Imagine listening to that in 1964 or something. It comes on the radio. I mean, it's just stunning. Absolutely stunning. I still don't know what the instrumentation is on the most of the Beach Boys songs. I can't even figure it out, actually. It's the Wrecking Crew doing stuff that you've never even heard before, getting different sounds out of instruments and combining it. You don't know what it is. But that great organ sound that they had back then, you know, it's just, oh, Lord. I wish they all could be Californian. I wish they all could. And so you have to do something with that too. Something with that too, that song. So we can do it. Because that's a song that just traps you into it and just like can't get out of it. It's not good. You gotta be careful. Anything that's static, you gotta be very careful of here. Repeat it over and over and over and over and over before you know it. Where's your creativity? Where's your creativity? See, this is the thing. So it's really important what we're going over here right now. Because this you know, you never think that music can make you depressed, great music, but it actually could, it might make you like the most depressed of anything because you lose your creativity just listening to it. You don't realize it's even happening. It's insidious. It's insidious. It may be the most insidious drug there is.
I keep the love and good vibration happening to. Gotta keep the love and good vibrations happening with.
You can do that. You can start to do your own vibration that way. Instead of gotta keep those loving good, you gotta keep those loving good vibrations happening with like that. Break it up, and so then you're like, I'm free. It sounds great adding that on, and I'm not stuck in the creativity anymore. So this is like mind blowing. I hadn't realized this until doing this video, really, of just, you know, what happened exactly, that you could get created. This world gets you stuck in creativity, listening to others' creativity. It gets put into form, and you lose your soul. You lose your irrepressibility. Total irrepressibility of what, which is what we really are. I have to do it louder because it's too hard to do this. Real sa sotto voce. Break it. And break it up like that way. Just make it, and you realize, wow, I'm being irrepressible again. I'm being irrepressible again. Welcome back, irrepressibility. Welcome back, irrepressibility. We're all irrepressible, actually. Gotta keep that love and good vibration happening to with God. Keep that love and vibration happening with, like that. You could do that. Gotta keep that love and good vibration happening with you. See different ways you can do it, right? This is just spontaneous. I just could just see what, you know, what can I do? You got to get out of that trap. That's the Beach Boys are the dangerous, dangerous trap. I think Brian Wilson got trapped in his own music. He became a basket case, mental basket case. It's horrifying, horrible. He went through hell. May have gotten trapped in his own brilliance, you know? Put it into form, some static form, and he felt trapped by it. That's why tortured musicians, you hear this, tortured musicians, I think they get trapped in their own brilliance. They lose their irrepressibility to just fly, you know. I'm not going to sing it this way this time. I'm going to just fly. George Jones actually sang the song differently every single time. That they drove the producers crazy. He'd never sing the same thing twice. That tells you something right there. He didn't get trapped in his own music so much, although he did go through incredible, maybe the most tortured musician of ever, George Jones, actually. Alcohol, cocaine, more alcohol, alcohol psychosis, just hideous stuff going on with him. Uppers, you know. But he wouldn't sing the same thing twice. I didn't like to. Maybe the people, it was driving him crazy because he felt like they're forcing me to sing it this way over and over and over, and I'm going crazy. I can't do that, because he can sing anything. Sing the phone book and he'd sound great. And he liked doing really creative stuff, like the love bug and thing book. Well, yeah, that itty bitty little teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. Boom, 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 boom. They know I've ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a tiny little kiss and a hug. And that little bit of teeny weeny thing they call the love bug. It's one of those kind of fun songs. You like doing these really fun songs like this. It's just like, wow, fantastic. George Jones, fantastic. Well, I tried to outrun it, but it finally caught up with me. How can I run from something that I can't see? Well, that little bitty little itty bitty little teeny weeny thing they call a love bug. Nobody's ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a tiny little kiss and a hug. Yeah, that itty bitty teeny weeny little thing they called a love bug. Oh, the little love bug. La 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 bug. La 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 da do do do. Boom bum ba dum ba dum dum da 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 da. So, you know, it's like maybe that's, you know, I got so depressed when I was young. And everybody said, well, you're so brilliant musically. Oh, my God, you're so amazing. But I got so depressed. I couldn't do anything. And the doctor said, nothing we can do for you. I've never seen anything like it. You're incurable. You're incurable. Because I never did know what was wrong. Nobody knew what was wrong. Is very likely I got trapped in brilliance, of creative brilliance, but in a static box, a beautiful box. It's like you're in a box, super beautiful box, but you're still in a box. You see? And that's not irrepressibility ing wow. That is not irrepressibility ing wow at all. It's very Baroque, you know, this super ornate, beautifully orchestrated Baroque box. And you think everybody's saying, oh my God, you're so fortunate, so amazing, you're so creative, blah, 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 blah. And here you are, like, totally depressed and despondent. How can I ever get out of this box? How can I ever? And nobody has a clue what's wrong. Rap. I've never done rap. So, well, actually, I've tried a couple of times. I'd be good at that too, actually. I think about telling the same thing, the minor thing, and the minor thought I gotta to do this, and the thing about saying, I'm gonna see another thing. Yeah, right. Well, how come I not seen another one to do this? I'm gonna think of that year. You see, it's so great. Don't worry, baby. Ooh, the start to that song. It's just so great. You can't help but just like be me transfixed. Yeah, just. Well, it's been building up inside of me for, oh, I don't know how long. That one's just like, whoa, it just grabs you and puts you in a box, a beautiful box. Which is hell. Yeah, it's hell, actually. So I get to sing these songs to get free of the box that the Beach Boys put me in. Yeah, I was in such a box by the time the Beatles came. I was already getting so depressed. You know, I lost my creativity. I'd sit there and listen. I get around. I just 100 times. I'm around. Get around. I get around. Yeah, get around. Woo! I get around. I getting bugged driving up and down the same old strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip. My buddies and me are getting real well known. Yeah, the bad guys know us and they leave us alone. I get around, round, round, round. I get around town to town. I'm a real cool head. I'm making real good bread. I get around, round. Woo, woo. Round, round, get around. I get around, yeah, get around. Woo, I get around. And I'm just like, wow. Like, wow, I want to hear that again, 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 again. But before too long, what happened to your own creativity? And people say, well, you know, you're not as creative as the Beach Boys. You know, you're not as creative as the Beatles. I say, yeah, I am. And they say, you're crazy. You know, what are your nutcase? You're a bunch of egomaniac. You know, say, no, I'm irrepressible. Everyone's irrepressible. You've just been so repressed, you don't realize you're irrepressible. So the Beatles came out of it. Ooh, I need your love, babe. Guess you know it's true. Hope you need my love, babe, just like I need you. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, the 8 days a week, I love you. 8 days a week is not enough to show I care. I love you every day, girl. Always on my mind. That, you know, you listen to that, and it's like that. You gotta admit the Beatles had a swinging beat. You get transfixed by that, the swinging Mersey beat of the Beach Boys. You know, Liverpool, that swing, that Hamburg stuff, and everything. It's just, boy, they had a swinging beat. You just me, hold me, ain't got nothing but love and fame. 8 days a week, 8 days a week, and it's like. Like a deer in headlights, like, and everybody says, you know, the Beatles are the greatest thing ever. And it's like, I said, no, but I'm still irrepressible, right? And it's, no, the Beatles are everything. You got to be like the Beatles. I said, no, I'm irrepressible. I can do anything. I'm not in a box. But you get put in a box by all these creative geniuses that come in the world, put it into static forming, and then it gets you down, and you lose the irrepressibility. You lose it. And then you get totally depressed, especially if you're used to it. You get so depressed. You're saying, I lost my life. I lost my soul. I'm a lost soul. Yeah. How can I find it again? And, you know, then you just go searching. What can I do? Well, you don't realize quite what happened, actually.
Ooh, I need your love, babe. Guess you know it's true.
See, just change it, right?
Oh, I hope you need my love, babe. Ooh, just like I need you. Hold me, love me. Hold me, love me. I ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days of the week. 8 days of the week.
And so you gotta try something a little different, right? Don't let them put you in a box. Don't let them put you in a box. The Beatles put everyone in a box. The Beatles and the Beach Boys, etc., put everybody in a box. We've been in a box ever since. They want you in the box because they want to sell you more stuff. Because you get depressed, they sell you more music. See, this is the problem with form. Form causes problems, gets us depressed, and they sell us more music. Where are we at now? Gambling everywhere. Gambling, gambling, gambling. That's like gambling, like it's like, you think, I'm going to get out of the box this time. I'm going to get out of the box this time. I'm going to get out of the box this time. I'm going to get out of the box this time. Like that. Gambling is super, super addictive. Drinking and gambling is just going to bury you. Because it's just like, you know, I'm in this terrible box, but, you know, I'm going to hit the jackpot. I'm going to get out of the box, that kind of thing. See what happens? So first they put you in a box, get depressed, then they turn you to gambling. Quite a racket in the world is going on. Actually, really hideous racket here, to say the least. To say the least. When you can just get out of the musical box, there's no desire to gamble at all. Do you think the gambling industry wants that? No, they want you in the box. So the Beatles put us in the box, and now we're going to Vegas and get busted. You know, busted in Vegas. I sat in front of the hotel with all the fountains. I was just watching all the people, just people watching. It's just like, what a trip that is. What a trip. They come in from all over the world. I'm here to get out of the box, you know. Yeah. Like that, they're going in. It's like, yeah, I gotta get out of the box. Gotta get out of the box. I know it's gonna happen. 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 What a trip, man. The folks that come to that place. The Bellagio. Yeah, out in front of the Bellagio. We had to pick somebody up in Vegas once, take him to Coachella Valley. And so we spent some time, I think, overnight. We stayed overnight. And I was just people watching. Look, the scene's like crazy. The people, the attitudes there. The hope, the false hope, the hope, the hustle, the hope, the hustle, the hope, the hustle. It's just, you know, hustle, hope, you know. Oh, you're in a box? Oh, here's a way to get out of the box. That's just another box. You know, box within boxes, within boxes, within boxes, within boxes. And of course, the people all making the filthy lucre off all of that, they hope the money's going to get them out of their box. And of course, it doesn't. Maybe if I have enough money, I'll get out of that box. I'll be irrepressible. I have enough money, I'll be irrepressible. No. No. Irrepressible's right now. It's got nothing. It's got nothing except right now. And right now, it's got everything. Irrepressibility has everything right now. It doesn't need a past. It doesn't need a future. Total irrepressibility. Got all options this instant. All options this instant. Never stuck in a box and trying to use the future to get out of a box that got into the past. Used to have CDs in cars. Now it's just all the stupid digital. I have to have a thumb drive with the digital file on the thumb drive, or download it on the phone. Also, I could do that. Yeah, I could do that and pay Amazon. It's such a pain. Amazon, they're always hustling you. They're such hustlers. They're such greedy hustlers, Amazon. I can't stand the platform, the way they operate. You know, they've asked me a million times, you know, do you want, you could have free shipping here, you know, for this, if you just join a 30-day free trial of Amazon Prime, and then a little tiny box. No, I don't want free shipping and great deals of Amazon Prime down below. Little, click on that. And every single time they ask you again, and it multiple times, really, you don't really want that? Are you sure? You know, why can't you just say, hey, you know, this is my response from here on in, is I don't want Amazon Prime. Okay, don't ask me again. No, they just keep relentlessly badgering you, relentless badgers. You know, Amazon just hired 400,000 new employees. Yeah, during the coronavirus scenario, 400,000 new employees. None of them know how to drive either. You want good drivers, UPS. Those drivers are great. They're great. They train them. They're strict. They got to know exactly what they're doing, what they can't do. These new Amazon van drivers, man, they just block your driveway. They block the road. They're a menace. Look, he's got 400,000 new drivers out just saying, woo, you know. just winging it. It's crazy. They're leaving like treats now for the UPS, for these people. We had a UPS driver go up to a house we were working on, and they have a box out there to say, thank you, delivery drivers, for your wonderful service here. Hey, here's some treats for you. And the guy's like getting all this candy and treats out and eating it from the box. And someone told me, yeah, that's a thing. People are just leaving all this food and treats out for the workers because they come multiple times every day to their house. Everybody's ordering stuff like crazy online. It's like 400,000 new employees. I read that just today. Is that true or is that a misprint? But it says 400,000. Maybe it's 40,000, but it could be 400,000. Possible. Yeah. Putting treats out for the Amazon. Don't get in a box. Speaking of boxes, everything comes in a box, doesn't it, to your house? Yeah. 8 days a week. How would you do that one? If I find a way. Yes. 8 days a week. Eight days a week. You can do something like that, right? 8 days a week. 8 days a week. I can't hit the tone because I'm singing so quiet. I can't do it. 8 days a week. And 8 days a week. Da 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 da, 8 days a week. Da 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 da, 8 days a week. Da 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 da, 8 days a week. And that fills in, it balances with 8 days a week. I love you. And do something with that too. 8 days a week. I love you. I love you. I'm the low. I'm not exactly sure we do on that one. La la la, love you. I la 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 la, la love you. I la ha ha you. I la 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 love you. In the various things that I la 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 love you. I la ha ha you. In the various things that I la ha 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 you. But you gotta have that Liverpool Puddleian accent there. I la ha 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 of you. I la ha 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 you. Yeah, jolly Liverpoolians we are. And yeah, that one's George. Oh, who are you? I'm Paul. Oh, yeah. John here. It's like, okay, Ringo. It's like, oh yeah. Like, bobblehead dolls. They're like bobblehead dolls. It's like, you know, with the Beatles. Yeah. These lovely Liverpoolians. We got a swinging beat, you know. Can't be beat. Yeah. They had that busking style. It really swung the music. There's no question about it. Fabulous beat. She loves you, yeah. With a love like that, you know, you should be glad. And say you lost your love when I saw her yesterday. You she's thinking of, and she told me what to say. Hey, she said she loves you, and you know that can't be bad. Yeah, she loves you, and you know you should be glad. Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. You know, it's like, yeah, that's the yeah came from. She loves you.